Garrick. I'm here again with one of the British gas workers who's in a position where they've been working for the company for now, I think, 10 years.
10 years, yes.
And obviously they've been put in a position where they are now looking at this fire and rehire situation, and you know, it's put him and his family into a desperate situation. Yeah, tell us a bit more about the story.
Yeah, so it's a hard time. So I've been here 10 years. Unfortunately, I haven't signed the contract, so I actually gave my band back yesterday. But unfortunately, I had no other choice. It's kind of left with the catch-22. It's just everything's going to change so much dramatically for me. It's just not worth the financial deficit it's going to cause. Like I said, I've been here for a very long time. I love British Gas. I've always looked out for the customers. The service in itself has been going down for so much longer. But it's just, for me, it's always, the company feels like it's declining. And you've got management above that are in the top dollar. They have no idea what it's like to be on the field. Yet they're making drastic changes. And I feel that the negotiations haven't been great for us. They've not really bothered. All they wanted to do, really, in my eyes, is when we was in strike, it was the 43rd day now. We had one of the coldest winters of the year. They wanted us back into work straight away just to cover that weekend. And then they never really wanted to negotiate with us anyway. So I feel it's kind of more like bully boy tactics. We've not been left with any other option but to leave. I've had no other option to go. And I just feel sorry for guys that have been here for so long. I mean, for me, I have another avenue to go down to, but some people, this is their life. And when you're kind of a noose around your neck, you've got no other option but to sign. There's no other way for people to go forward. It's awful.
Understood. So what does the future hold, do you think, for the others who are going to have to accept this contract?
I can't, in my personal opinion, when I joined British Gas 10 years ago with the company, I loved it. Everything was brilliant. Like I said, it's in decline. I can't see a good future for people that work here. They're not going to change something again, say in 2 years' time the pension comes along, they'll be all over the pension going next. So I think they're just slowly trying to chip away. They want people, I don't know if they want people to go, but no one's going to want to stay at
thanks so much for your advice and your comments today. We stand in solidarity with you. The big thing we're saying is, if you see a British Gas van, give them a hoot, give them a wave.
We're always there when we're driving about, getting a little motion. If you do, we'll be great.
We'd just like you to show the love, basically.
Yeah, tonight. Up their days, and I'm losing money, losing financial contracts for something great people. We're still out there, and even we're still here now, regardless of what's happening. Even though I've left, I still love the company and all the guys here, so I understand the solidarity with them and be here for them, even though I've gone.
Wonderful. Look, Phil, thanks for taking time with me. I really appreciate it. Obviously down here with the protest, you'll see there's a fair few people have already turned up. Ultimately, we want to make sure that you get the message out to friends and family that this isn't the way to treat workers, especially during this pandemic that we're in at the moment. Thanks very much for listening in.